Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Russian Fishing 4. So it took me some time because the last patch they nerfed really hard the game with the leaders and all that stuff. And I think the hardest area that they hit was Skure Lake. And yeah, that's the lake that I fish the most. I'm almost fishing here the whole time. So the thing is, I'm going to show you guys that you can still make some money. So what I'm doing at the moment, so at the start it was not that easy, but you need to troll. If you go spin fishing with this setup, the pike is going to destroy your rig. That's how it works. So with trolling it still works. So what did they change for the guys that don't know? They didn't nerf the fish biting, but they simply nerfed the gear. So to give you guys an example, a lot of people know that. So I call the Trident Everest, so I can go to 22 kilogram of test. But the main problem is that the trout here and the chars, they are seeing the line. So in the past we just fished with braid 25 kilograms. But now we only can use a leader or we need to use fluoro. But the main problem with fluoro is that the maximum is 17.4 kilograms, so they nerfed my gear with 10-15 kilogram, and I cannot do a lot about it. You can go with the steel leader still, you can go with the breadline still, but you are going to catch a lot less fish than before. So that's a nerf. I cannot do a lot about it. We just need to adjust. I'm not the guy that needs to save this game, so that's not my point. I can just show you guys how you can overcome this problem a little bit. I make again really nice money, but you need to troll, as I already said. So first of all, so what you need to do is I'm going to show you guys a setup. So you don't need to go with the leader, you can just buy this. It's very expensive, so the 7.4 kilogram, you just put it on and that's enough. So don't put the leader on it. You can go with mono and put the leader on it, but that's not going to solve anything because the leader is 17.4 kilogram. So why would you go with like a normal line that is higher than that? So it's a little bit pointless. Just go with this setup. I'm going always with the Funky Minnow, the S11, because it works really well here. So all the trophy Kyori chars on the Russian server, the big ones are caught with this one. Therefore, I always use it because this is my goal in the game. If I got the trophy Kyori char or the rare one and I got the first place, most of the time I think I'm going to stop playing this game. So that's my goal at the moment. So with my other setup, and of course still the Super Duty, so that's the line. Take the 31 kilogram. It's not really needed what I'm saying now. If it is more than your reel, you will be okay. So the other setup is just the same, but now we are going with Hunter 1003. It's very good for the Savant trout. It's a very good overall lure, this one, this color. It works really well every day. So yeah, that's it. Another thing that I want to show you guys is the weather in Kyori. So it needs to be cold. If it is not cold, trout is not biting because they are used to cold weather. So if it's 10-9 Celsius is really good, and under it is really good. But if you go over it, most of the time you're not going to catch a lot of fish. So this night or yesterday night, I was in Dream, his stream, and he was doing a giveaway for an Everest, and it was 21 Celsius. And I will show you guys what I got. So this is what you get if it is too warm. You don't get fish. So this is one day, you guys can see it. So it's 1 hour, and this is one day, but when it is cold. So you guys already can see the difference. So this is from yesterday, and all the other fish is from one day today. So you can catch a lot of fish still. So that's the problem. So what do you need to do? You can play another game or you go to another lake. That's all what you can do. There is not a solution that you can do. The trout is just not biting. I tried to go a little bit deeper into the water because I was thinking maybe they go deeper because it's more cold there. But yeah, it doesn't matter. I don't think it matters in this game. Sometimes you don't catch a fish and that's it. End of the story, and you need to go to do something else. For today, you guys can still see you can make a lot of money. You can catch a lot of fish here. So this is my one day. So you guys can see it. 4 kilogram pike, 4 kilogram Kyori char. So this is all with the setup that I just showed you guys. So I was really amazed that that setup can handle very easy the fish. I got even a Kuora char with that setup that was 9 kilograms. And the fight was not that hard. I still need to get the trophy. But yeah, trophies is not that easy anymore, even with the Fluoro. So yeah, it's already the second nerf that they did, because the first one was the migration. So they just said we fixed the migration, but that means, yeah, if you let the fish go to another position 300 meters into the surface down, yeah, nobody's going to catch that fish. Okay, he's sitting there, but nobody can reach it. Okay, it's not really a nerf, but it's a nerf, take it from me. And this is the second nerf, but still, you can make some nice money, but the trophies are gone. I still remember my time that I made the video, 800 silver in 3 days. Yeah, you're not going to have that anymore in Kuora. That's how it is, that's how the game is. I cannot help it. So, you can still make some nice profit. So, yeah, another thing that is very important. I did now 20-25 hours in this place, and I didn't lose one setup. I only lost a setup when I used mono, but with Fluoro, like I do it now, if you always keep pressure on the pike, and with rolling you keep pressure on the pike because you're always going forward, he cannot cut your line. So I didn't have it that I lost a lure. I lost the lure with the mono, I lost the lure one time that I just stopped and went to the little baby to give him milk, and my lure was still in the water. So if you give slack on your line, he's going to cut it with his teeth. Therefore, it's not so good that you fish with spinning here at the shore, because you're going to lose so many equipment, it's unbelievable. If you want to go with feeders, yeah, it's the same problem, because you cannot put on the feeders, you cannot put a steel leader on it. So live bait, yeah, it's too dangerous going for the trout. So there is only one very good solution, that's trolling. What I'm showing you guys, other things are not going to work anymore that good, because you're going to lose so much equipment that it's not worth to fish for. You need to imagine if you lose a hunter. I lost a hunter, I think, was 50-60 silver. I lost a minnow with like berserker hooks on it. Yeah, it's not worth it, because you need to fish like one day for free to pay back, yeah, a stupid mechanic in my opinion. So that was it. You can make nice money. Now I'm going to show you guys how you need to go around. So let's go to the map. So you just need to go this way again. So always go around the island. Yeah. I cannot say more than that. Just you guys know the route. Just go like this. If it is raiding, just go here in the pike alley and go to the higher funky minnow, the blue one. So the highest that you can have, because rainy days is trophy pike day. So that's it a little bit, I think. Did I say everything? So you guys know the setup. You know the... yeah, my thoughts about the stuff. You know what I'm going to do, guys? I'm going to sell the fish, just to check it out. At the night, it's not that active, this lake for trout, I mean. You can get the Kuora char, they are biting at night too, and the Arctic char. But I think if you want to make a little bit more profit, you need to go for the burbop. So like the guys are doing here. So just get pieces of fish, I think it's called, put a nice hook on it, go to the island, throw in the hole, or go to the pike alley and throw in the hole there too, and then you're going to catch a burbot. So you can maximize a little bit your profit more. If I go for the burbot at night, I make more money. So you can make nice money still, but yeah, I'm a little bit afraid what is going to happen when I get a trophy on my line, because it's only a test. So the main problem is, in the past, yeah, if you got better gear, you can catch more fish in good time zones and very good active time. But now that's not the case anymore, because yeah, they nerfed the gear. That's how it is. So yeah. Okay. Let's have a look, guys. Let's go to the shop here. And let's have a look how much that I made today. I'm just going to do the day today. So I think it was until here. So 129 silver, and this was a very good day. So It was not a bad day, so that was it a little bit, guys. I hope that the video helps you guys a little bit. You can still make some money in Kyoro. It's not totally dead, not yet, because yeah, I'm still waiting for the next patches. I always got the impression that the next patches, I think they are going to get the feeders down, and then it's the floaters, I guess, because yeah, it's every time that they got a new patch, they do one thing, try to prevent that people make silver. That's how it works. So that was it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Have fun in Kyoro Lake. I hope that the video helps you guys to get some money, because it's a very nice lake, very nice fish. I like trout, therefore I always fish here. So let's hope that they keep it this time like this. Let's hope that we get a little bit heavier fluoro lines, maybe 25 kilograms. But yeah, I don't think it's going to happen. So see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.